So the next speaker is Dr. Teresa Pollicino. Is she trying to share the screen? Yes. Dr. Pollicino is professor of molecular medicine and head of the Molecular Clinical Hepatology Laboratory at the University Hospital in Messina, Italy. Teresa?
Thank you very much for the introduction. Hello, everybody. I'm very happy to be here. So, in 2018, as we know, a consensus meeting was held in Taormina, Italy, where a group of experts reviewed and updated the recent developments of occult HPV infection. The expert participants reached an agreement regarding the definition of OBI, that is a condition characterized by the presence of replication-competent HPV DNA in the liver, with the presence or absence of HPV DNA in the blood of people who test negative for HPS antigen by currently available assays. In OBI, the HPV DNA in the form of cccc DNA is in a silent or very low replicative state due to the host immune or epigenetic control. And therefore, when serum HPV DNA is detectable, it is invariably in a low viremic range, usually less than 200 international units per ml, and may only be intermittently detected. So based on this acquisition and on the agreed definition on OBI, HPV DNA in the liver is the gold standard biomarker for OBI diagnosis. However, standardized and valid assays for HPV DNA detection in the liver are not yet available, as we know. And I have to say that the variety of studies that these are only some of the studies that has been performed during the years have used certainly not the cccc DNA approach to detect occult HPV DNA, but in-house PCR approach that show the different sensitivity and specificity, leading to different results in terms of occult HPV detection. And so the updated OBI statements publication underlined that the ideal method of diagnosis of OBI is the detection of cccc DNA in the liver. And the recommended methods include multiple nested PCR techniques to amplify at least three different viral genomic regions, real-time PCR assays, or the droplet digital PCR assay. Any method is used, what is important is include primer sets that allow the detection of replication competent HPV DNA. And this study from Antonina Smedile, Mario Rizzetto from Turin analyzed liver tissue from 100 anti-HBC positive liver donors, and by multiple nested PCR, OBI was found in 52% of the cases. And the droplet digital PCR was applied to study the cccc DNA that was found in 52% of the OBI positive patients. And in these slides, there are the preliminary results of a study conducted in collaboration with Massimo Lebrero Group in Lyon. And the droplet digital PCR appears to perform better than the real-time, the quantitative PCR in the detection of cccc DNA in OBI individuals. And in most of the cccDNA positive OBI positive patients, we could detect by the digital PCR also a small amount of pregenomic RNA, suggesting that by this technical approach, it is possible to assess the cccDNA transcriptional activity in vivo. So considering, as Maura said before, that liver biopsy is not always available because of the invasiveness of the diagnostic approach, the diagnosis of OBI is generally based on the detection of HPV DNA in the blood of HBs antigen negative individuals. So for a proper diagnosis of OBI, the sensitivity of the assays used in the detection of HPS antigen and HPV DNA is of particular importance. The use of an HPS antigen assays with an inadequate sensitivity, for example, may lead to false negative HPS antigen results and to a misdiagnosis of OBI in people with in patients with overt HPV infection. The currently available assays, most of them have a low limit of detection of 0.5 international unit per ml. However, more recently, more sensitive assays are available, such as the Lumipulse from Fujirebio and the high sensitive Architect from Abbott that show a tenfold sensitivity improvement. And as demonstrated in this study, the re-evaluation by high-sensitive HPS antigen assays revealed the positivity of HPS antigen in approximately 50% of HPV carriers in whom HPS antigen seroclearance was confirmed by conventional assays. So with these improved assays, it should be taken into consideration the reclassification of patients initially defined as OBI or even functionally cured as chronic carrier with low HPS antigen levels. And as for the HPS antigen assays, also HPV DNA assays with inadequate sensitivity may lead to false negative HPV DNA results and may lead to a missed diagnosis of OBI. The commercially available test for serum HPV DNA quantification, as we see and as we know, target a single HPV genomic region, and the lower limit of detection is around 5-10 international units per ml. And these assays can detect most, but not all, OBI. It is recommended in the updated OBI statements that because HPV DNA is usually present at very low concentration in the serum and may only be intermittently detected in OBI people, testing blood samples collected at more than one time point, as well as testing DNA extracts from no less than 1 ml of serum or plasma, is recommended for a proper diagnosis of OBI. These are results from our study performed to evaluate possible reactivation of occult HBV infection in direct acting antivirus cured HCV patients. And to this aim, we analyzed the longitudinally collected serum sample from these patients by a multiple nested PCR. And as we can see, we found HPV DNA could be intermittently detected in many of these patients. Overall, HPV DNA was present in 25% of these patients at baseline, and in more than 50% of the cases 3 months after stopping the DR therapies. Interestingly, HPV DNA amounts 3 months after the stop of therapy were significantly higher than the amounts detected at basal time. And the HBs antigen and the correlated antigen biomarkers were negative at baseline and remain persistently negative in all the serial collected serum samples. It's important to refer that no patients experienced an OBI reactivation during the follow-up. As we know, the molecular tests are not always available, so the anti-core, the anti-HBC is frequently commonly used as a surrogate biomarker to identify OBI, and in the updated OBI statements, it is reported that the detection of anti-HBC in the blood may be used indeed as a surrogate biomarker to identify OBI in blood or organ donors or in people who are about to receive immunosuppressive therapies. However, the absence of anti-HBC does not rule out OBI, and this because it is well known that at least 20% of OBI are hepatitis B antibody negative. Considering the HPV serum marker profile, OBI individuals can be categorized in seropositive OBI, anti-HBC and or anti-HBs positive, and seronegative OBI, anti-HBC and anti-HBs negative. And from the immunological point of view, it is known that circulating HPV-specific T cells can be present at comparable level in anti-HPC positive and anti-HPC negative OBI patients. However, in vitro expansion of HPV-specific T cells and interferon gamma production is much stronger in seropositive OBI than in seronegative OBI cases. And this study was performed by Carlo Ferrari, Gabriele Missale group with and our group, and circulating HPV specific T cells could be proposed as an indirect biomarker of OBI. Of course, such hypotheses need to be confirmed by other studies. Finally, also the evaluation of anti-HBC levels can be useful in the diagnosis of OBI. Data from the Caviglia studies report that median levels of anti-HBC IgG are significantly higher in OBI positive individuals compared to OBI negative subjects. So in summary, for an appropriate diagnosis.
We must be finishing soon.
Yes, OBI. Yes, the sensitivity, yes, just to sum up, the sensitivity of HBs antigen and HPV DNA assays is a main issue. The recent more sensitive HBs antigen assay can improve the detection rate of low level of HBs antigen, and this poses the question for a rescreening of OBI samples. The droplet digital PCR assay appear to increase the rate of OBI detection, but it is important to evaluate systematically this technical approach in the OBI setting. Anti-HBC quantification and circulating HPV specific T cells may be interesting biomarkers, but needs further confirmation. And to conclude, to date, HPV DNA is still the only reliable diagnostic marker of OBI. And the lack of standardized diagnostic procedure for OBI detection remains an important unmet diagnostic and clinical need. So thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Teresa. There is one quick question for you. The question is, what is the HCC risk in occult patients? If you could take 2 seconds to give us the answer.
Yes, the risk for HCC remain in occult infection because HCC DNA can be even if at low level active, but there is another important molecular reason that in occult HBV infected patients, frequently we can find integrated HBV DNA. And this is a main point for HCC development, yes, in my opinion.
Thank you so much. If you have further questions, you can address them directly to Dr. Policino.